John, Rob Anderson, Clean Power Wash, Salisbury, Maryland. So I want to talk about booster pump plumbing. I've had a couple people recently ask me about booster pumps and how to plumb them properly and whatnot. So we're going to just kind of start here with your booster pump. For the simplicity of this, we're going to assume that you have got a pro switch or some other thing instead of having to show the recirculation kit. If you got that, so be it. So the easy part of this is once you go to your outlet of your booster, it's going to come out. You're going to have a three-way ball valve. Okay. So your water is either going to, or solution is either going to go down here to your dump line. Or it's going to come up here and go over to your hose reel. Super artistic, by the way. So, I like to, since this outlet's 3/4 inch or 1 inch, whatever, I tend to run almost all of our plumbing as 3/4. So you have 3/4 out, 3/4 ball valve, comes over here, reduces to whatever fitting at your hose reel. And here you can come out of this 3/4 and go to really any section of dump or priming hose. You want it to be long enough so that it can basically reach to or be pretty close to the ground when you're priming that into your 5 gallon bucket. Now up here, before your booster, that's where it kind of gets a little bit more difficult. So I'm gonna draw a little proportioner. That comes out, comes over here, and we've got another three-way valve. Put our little line out of there. That's the lever coming out of it. So coming in here, and then this is going to be, so we've got the PP side, and we've got the, and yes, I just said PP, we've got the H2O side. Give me 1 second here. All right, so we're back. All right, so from the water side, you can do it a couple of different ways. You can either be force feeding, and so here we're going to go ahead and throw another, either a straight up T, where you can have a ball valve here, and a ball valve here. I'm sure that the plus sign is probably not the best thing for that, but ball valve. Okay, so you can either do that or you can do a three-way valve. I like the idea of having, this is just a straight T, and then having a ball valve here and a ball valve up here. Now, one of them is going to go to sorry, so we'll take from here. We're gonna do hose reel. So on here, you'd actually have, from your hose reel, you're gonna have water comes in this way, coming into your hose reel. It's coming out over here. Now this is either gonna go right here into your, to that line, and you'd have a T that would then send it up to here to your buffer tank. Okay, so that's filling. That's your default. You could obviously, you'd throw a throw another ball valve there. What that enables you to do is basically when you need to prime it, you close the ball valve off to the buffer tank, big old buffer tank, right? And then that's going to force feed all water this way. You open this valve up, that forces it through there and allows you to go through here to prime. The other way, we actually have it set that we can prime both ways with it on our trucks. But when we have our buffer tank, we've got 2 inch plumbing that comes out of there and it's going to go right to this. So then you're gonna get more flow in general out of a properly plumbed 275 gallon or 500 gallon or whatever size buffer tank than you will from your household pressure. We get upwards of 17 to 20 gallons per minute of flow out of a single 2 inch pipe out of just a 275 tank with our, when they're tandemed, we get even more. And then obviously this is going to go to your pressure washer. Etc. But by having this plumbing right here, this water, as long as this valve and the tank water in here pretty much are at least even, or this is a little bit higher than the amount of water that you've got, or where that three-way valve is, that's going to work. So all we have to do at that point, we keep this valve shut, or really doesn't matter, but we open this valve up. It's going to let all that flow come through there, forces through here, and helps you prime out really quickly. The other nice thing is that all this water that's going to be coming out of that buffer tank, and it should be the same really for your water coming from your supply hose reel, that there shouldn't be any extra air bubbles. A lot of guys, when they have these boosters, the three-way valve is going to be right here in your check valve. So sometimes, I mean, if you figure this is 6 to 8 inches and then probably adding another 4 or 5 inches up top, you're about a foot that you need of water in there. Which really, if you're getting to a job site and you're going to start doing some work, you're probably going to have at least that much water in there. I know this can be kind of overcomplicated to a degree. Again, so we've got our proportioner coming over here. So this is your chemical side, this is your water side, this is your tank supply coming this way, and this is from the force fed or from the house pressure coming through this way. There are lots and lots of different ways you can, you know, have all these spread out. You can have them kind of close by. We are redoing one of the trucks, and so I will show you the updated plumbing on that once we finish it. But this is all the real basic part. And obviously, if you did have a, little recirc kit, and that goes out there, that would just be that. That's the only other complexity that adds to it. Just a couple of other tips on here. We have set it so that all of these right now, right here, we have a cam lock that goes to that hose. And this has, these are all male cam locks fitting. So we can just cam lock on, cam lock off. And actually right here, each booster now has a three-way valve. And so this is cam locked and that's cam locked. So we can take one pump out quickly, throw the next one in, and get back to working. So hope that helps y'all.